grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let us pray. O God, we pray this day for all who have a song they cannot sing, for all who have a burden they cannot bear, for all who live in chains they cannot break, for all who have wandered homeless and cannot return, for all those who are sick and those who tend them, for those who wait for loved ones and wait in vain, for those who live in hunger and for those who will not share their bread, for those who are misunderstood and for those who misunderstand, for those who are captives and for those who are captors, for those whose words of love are locked within their hearts, and for those who yearn to hear those words. Have mercy on these, O God. Have mercy upon us all. Amen. The peace of Christ be with you.
And also with you.
Into our darkness, doubt, and despair, come, Jesus Christ, be our light. Into our sorrow, sickness, and grief, come, Christ Jesus, be our comfort. Into each conflict, division, and war, come, Christ Jesus, be our hope. When we call to you, hear our cry. Do not abandon us, but draw near. Come, Christ Jesus, be our light. Amen. For those of you at home, please, this is the time to light your lantern or your candle.
Reading from John. Jesus said, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also."
Thomas said, "Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?"
Jesus said, "I am the way and the truth and the life.
Thank you.
Jesus said, I will not leave you orphaned. I am coming to you. In a little while, the world will no longer see me, but you will see me because I live. You also will live.
Jesus said, I have said these things to you while I am still with you. But the Advocate, the Holy Spirit, whom God will send in my name, will teach you everything and remind you of all that I have said to you. Peace I leave with you. My peace I give to you. I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled. And do not let them be afraid.
Make it ever true.
Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
Many among us are troubled and afraid, individuals, families, communities, churches, and nations. We will play music as you take time to pray for people and situations in the community and the country and in the world that are filled with fear. As you pray, your response might be not afraid. I'll play music in the background as you take your reflective time. Gathering our many prayers into one, we pray. Merciful God, source of all goodness and life, into your wide embrace, we pray for all for whom we pray. Grant that we, having turned towards you in prayer, now might turn towards you in peace and tend the world with justice and mercy, for the sake of Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Peace. We all long for peace. Peace from worry, from our own inner turmoil, or peace in the midst of family conflict, or peace in divided communities, or in our divided country, or peace from between nations, or in a troubled world. Peace always just seems just out of reach. We begin to achieve it, and we begin to breathe a sigh of relief, and then it seems to just melt away. Sometimes conflicts in one community or in one part of our lives draw communities together, and sometimes it divides us. We have lost most of our World War II generation, but if you think back or what you've heard about it, World War II seemed to draw people together, at least half of the world together. This country drew together to come together to pull everybody together for the war effort. Half the world pulled together to try to defeat the powers that were against them. Everyone seemed to all work together for one common purpose. At other times, conflict divides us. During the Vietnam War era, it seemed to pull people apart, people who were on opposite sides, much as we are struggling with today. 9/11 pulled us together. When that great tragedy happened, we came together as one nation. And now today we seem to be all going into our different corners. Conflict is a funny thing. Sometimes we come together, sometimes we pull apart. Together is a word we need to remember, because without together we can't survive. God created us to be together in community, to pull together, to share our God-given gifts and talents, so that we can become the community God created us to be, to make the world a better place, to use our differences to create something new and better, rather than to judge each other. Jesus said, the kingdom of God, the reign of God is at hand. He ushered in the reign of God, and then he left us with the responsibility to help make that happen, to come to fulfillment. And that is our responsibility. Christ's death, resurrection, and ascension ushered in the reign of God. And now we are commissioned to continue working with God to bring that to fulfillment. And we use all our differences to make that happen. When Christ will come again is when it will be in fulfillment. And maybe Christ won't come again until we can come together again. All that sounds so lofty and impossible, but really it's simple, and it begins with each one of us. We can gradually build walls around ourselves, or we can pull those walls down. It's our choice. Walls are easy to build, and before we know it, we've walled ourselves in and cut ourselves off from new ideas and new people and new possibilities. And we become so walled in to everyone and everything outside of ourselves that that everything becomes an enemy, and we get consumed with anger, and conflict becomes a way of life. Taking down walls a brick at a time is what's important to do, and we can help each other do that. Listening to each other is the first thing to do, is to begin to listen to each other, listen to different opinions, and not judge those opinions, just to listen, put ourselves in somebody else's shoes, to imagine what their lives would be and what their perspective is and why they think the way they do. Maybe wonder what their life has been like. There's a whole world of room for other ways of thinking and experiences that we just need to remember that God made us different for a reason. Because of our differences, we can create new things, new possibilities, and realize that God is doing new things with us just because of our differences. And when something feels new, it feels strange, but instead of rushing to judgment, let's just relax and see where it's leading us. Let's take down our walls and see what God is doing, what new thing God is imagining for us. Sometimes one prayer that maybe we can just think about is, Lord, help me to see what's new, what new and creative thing you are working in your life and in me, instead of turning to fear or judgment or anger or hiding behind our walls. Help me find the good in your people, in your world, and in your creation. Another mantra. I have this bracelet that I wear, especially during Lent. Each bead, you can say a sentence or a little sentence or a little prayer. And those are some of the things that I do. Help me see what's new and creative, what new and creative thing you are doing in my life today. And just to say it over and over again. Or what new thing is somebody going to say to me today? What new possibilities are happening? Help me take down any walls I've built. That's another thing I can say over and over when I have this. Or help me understand someone that that maybe I'm struggling with today. I find this really helpful to kind of focus on one thing that maybe I'm struggling with. Help us work for peace. Help me be a person of peace. That's another little mantra I can do, because we can only start with ourselves. And that's all we can do is begin with ourselves and pray for peace. It's so important to do. So next time you're tempted to judge or tempted to close off and turn around and run away in fear, say a little prayer. Lord, what is this you're putting in front of me? What new thing can I learn from this person or these words that I'm hearing that seem fearful or strange? Open my eyes, open my heart to what new thing you are working in the world. Let me hear the possibilities and see what God has in store for us. And help us all be people of peace. It's so important today that we open our minds to peace. Amen. And during these weeks of Lent, we're remembering the events that led up to the crucifixion. Jesus had come to bring hope into the world, but at every step there were those who willingly tried to put out that light. He brought grace and forgiveness, but these gifts were often rejected by those filled with hatred and fear. We read in Matthew's Gospel in the 12th chapter, it was the Sabbath, and Jesus went to the synagogue, where there was a man with a paralyzed hand. Some people were there who wanted to accuse Jesus of doing wrong, so they asked him, "Is it against our law to heal on the Sabbath?" Jesus answered, "What if one of you has a sheep and it falls into a deep hole on the Sabbath? Will you not take hold of it and lift it out? And a man is worth so much more than a sheep." So then our law does allow us to help someone on the Sabbath. Then Jesus said to the man with the paralyzed hand, "Stretch out your hand." The man stretched out his hand and it became well again, just like the other one. Then the Pharisee left and made plans to kill Jesus. Even when Jesus was healing, there were those who could not accept the power and mercy of God. As the Pharisee left to make plans to kill Jesus for healing on the Sabbath, a little of the light which had come into the world was snuffed out by people Jesus had come to save. And we snuff out two lights this week. Would you like to join me in praying the closing prayer? O God of wisdom, make us wide in your ways. O one who judges all with justice, may we overcome our fears so that we are able to guide and give good counsel to those who present themselves to us on their journey home to you, and give voice to the vision your world invokes and your love clarifies. Please be to you forever and ever. Amen. The peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, guard your hearts and your minds in Jesus Christ. Amen.